Duke has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Receiver, and that's a first down.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. He's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Third down, 12 yards to go. Ball on the 37.
My 52, my 52. Red 2,
motion.
X,
motion.
7.
Motion, motion, bump, 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 bump.
Go. He chucks it downfield. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. And this one is a beauty. They'll bring him down at the 27.
The Blue Devils and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
Second and 12. Ball on the 25-yard line. Just throws this one away.
Corner of sitting back and reading the quarterback's eyes. Good job of disguising coverage as well.
From their own 32-yard line, first down. Pitch out to the right and tackle behind the line.
That'll bring up second and 11.
The middle. Tackle at the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line, it's third down. They go with the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss.
That brings up fourth and 11.
Booming kick. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws them.
He's taken down at about the 47-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
Bring him down right around the 44-yard line. It's second and 13. Ball on the 44-yard line. And he's hit immediately. Gets to about the 31-yard line.
Brad, I think offensive coordinators spend more time focusing on two areas for an offense, third down conversions and red zone offense. Right now, this offensive coordinator has to be really happy with the way this offense is executing in their third downs. That's the second time they've been able to get a first down in this drive on third down.
They'll work the left. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Throws a bullet over the middle. Big play, and it's first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Two on the carry. They're at the five. It's second down. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. Touchdown, Duke!
In this territory, but they look totally in control there.
And he hits the PAT. An 11-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Blue Devils are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
He steps up at about the 31. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Quick pass, and he's taken down at about the 37-yard line.
Receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. We're through one quarter. Duke's lead is a touchdown. we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Knees at the 40. Excellent open field tackle. From the 37-yard line, first down. He's tackled at the 29.
That makes it second and two.
He's at the 20. Tackle made right around the 16-yard line. From the 16-yard line, it's first down.
Brought down around the 11-yard line.
He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
We got a third and six here. Ball on the 11.
Red two. Three.
And he hits him hard at the 15. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Duke holds a 4-point lead.
Here we go.
And they make the stop at the 33.
That makes it second and two.
Third and five. Ball on the 30-yard line. And down he goes to the 33-yard line. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
The defense is going to head to the sideline with a real sense of accomplishment, knowing that they've just shut this offense down.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Moving around the corner. He's knocked out of bounds around the 31-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
They bring the quarterback down.
Calling a loss of 12 yards. That'll bring up third and long.
Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long.
Hey, Mike 52.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
Hey.
They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's tackled at the 39-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Duke is up by four. And he throws it away. It's second and 10. Ball on the 39. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 46-yard line. And they'll get him in the backfield.
The defense was playing the run all the way, and they got it right. Nice work.
Kansas just took their first time out. Catch. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 16-yard line, it's second down.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Two, 20.
Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Go, here we go, here we go.
Makes it out to about the 26. First and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. And he's tackled at about the 35.
That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Slings it. Tackle around the 46-yard line.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Heading for the corner. He's at the 40. Knocked out of bounds around the 32-yard line.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
This is the eighth play of this drive. He gets hit out of bounds around the 29-yard line. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. He's on the run. Ball is loose, fumble. Scoops up the loose ball. He's taken down right around the 20. He scrambles, runs with it, and he's got room. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. Throws down. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. Kansas to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with, because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game. The offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
Here we go, Hunt!
And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. He's to the 40. And they finally tackle him at the 50-yard line. The Blue Devils taking their first time out of the half. He's hit and taken down.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. They might just want to squib this one. Only a few seconds left here before halftime. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
They'll bring him down at the 49-yard line. So we've played two quarters. This one's all even at 10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Tied at the half, each team's move has been countered by the other. So far, nobody's been able to establish checkmate or really even generate much momentum. So what is each team, what's the most important thing for the second half for one team to gain an edge in this game?
Well, it seems like there has been an answer, and at some point, you know, you just got to get your offense and defense both working together. You know, when you do score, how about you get a stop so you can get your offense back and continue to add to the lead? And sometimes it's hard. Sometimes, you know, the game swings and it goes one way and you can't stop it, and then it comes back the other way. So I think maybe it's a special teams play. You know, maybe it's something off the radar that you're used to, maybe a big punt return, a blocked punt, but so far, the offenses and defenses seem even. Maybe you can get an edge on the special teams.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. And he's immediately tackled. Just throws this one away. From their own 37-yard line. Second down. Here we go. scrambling around. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. So that sack leaves them with some work to do. It's third down and 14. Hit immediately.
That makes it fourth and four.
It's away and it's a booming punt. So this one goes into the end zone and that'll be a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Ball's completely stopped immediately.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down.
Defense. They were expecting the pass play and they defended it very well.
That makes it fourth and 12.
Oh, excellent punt. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Quick pass, and he's taken down at the 50.
That makes it second and eight.
Caught with room to work. Steps out of bounds at the 44.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it third and one. That makes it first and 10.
Complete. He's got room. Tackle made around the 24-yard line.
Number 52 makes the tackle at the 24-yard line. That'll bring up second and three.
Inside the 10.
That makes it first and goal.
Couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
It was a pretty good play here by the junior safety stepping up and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
We've got second and goal. 5 yards to the goal line. He's tackled at the 3 yard line. Make a stop. Fourth down and goal to go. We're at the 1 yard line. A unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. Brought down right around the 14-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. So the tailback's going to come away with a first down on the play.
Well, that's a strong run. It makes a statement that you can run the ball like that.
Scramble, but he's sacked.
That's around 8 yards. That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Green 9, green 9. Blue 4.
Got a man. Watch out here. He's out to the 30. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Gets rid of this one.
Hey, number 8's coming. Number 8's Mike. Mike.
Mike 52. Mike 52.
Red 2.
And down he goes at about the 43-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position of this football game. And this one is a beauty. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Makes it to the 22-yard line. So at the end of the third quarter, and a 10-10 tie in this game. To the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter.
Down. Black 80.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
From their own 21-yard line, it's third down. He airs it out. The defender had it and then dropped it. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He's taken down at the 31. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. And he's tackled right away. And the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain.
That brings us second and one.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home. The blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
Tackle him at the 22. So we've got a first down after a great running play. Pass out to the tight end, but it's incomplete. To convert here on another third down.
Red two, green nine, go!
Pulls it in and he's in the open field. Tackled around the 12-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights.
And with that, all the pressure now shifts back to the other side. That's what a good kicker can do.
Kansas is ready to kick it away. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Here they come. Throws complete. He's got room to work. That was a close one, but the ball goes out of bounds. Second down and five. Ball on the 30-yard line.
You ain't doing nothing today.
They come out in a five-wide set. Tries to thread the needle. It's picked off. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. Oh, no. They really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. Kansas is up by three. And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 19.
Dog four.
And he tackles him hard at the 39-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Yeah. gets it up, and it's long enough. And he missed it off the upright. They threw a pick the last time out. Should be interesting to see what they do this time.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Just over 2 minutes in the game. He's out of bounds, right around the 34.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 15.
Fires it out. And bring him down around the 43-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Three down.
Where's 52? Watch 52.
He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
That's a big first down for this offense. Remember, the clock is a big-time factor here. They're driving late in the game, maybe to decide the outcome of the game. You've got to keep an eye on that clock as you move the ball down the field.
He's hit and taken down.
Second and four.
Now he tries to buy some time. Scoots it up. They bring him down in the backfield. To get back in this game here in the fourth, this third and goal is vital. Tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it. Duke's going to take their first time out of the half. Quick throw to a big, big stop on fourth down here late in the fourth quarter. If you love defense, you're loving this game right now because they're the ones throwing all the punches, and all the offense can do is duck. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. Under a minute left. Feeds it to the back, and he's level at the 41-yard line. The Blue Devils use their second timeout. It's second and nine. Ball on their own 41. Up the middle for a nice game. Duke will use their final timeout. That's a great tackle at the 46-yard line. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. The Blue Devils, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.